Memo Writing for ME 263, Part 2, by Zachary Koppelman. You are judged by your written communication. If your writing is unclear, sloppy, or unprofessional, your work may be viewed as useless. Results mean nothing if your audience does not understand what you did. This vidcast continues revising the same poorly written memo from Part 1. Here's the next sample. This change will increase cost and production time and may require a re-evaluation of the materials. Because the failures have been analyzed, however, we are positive the solution will work. This sample is clearer than previous samples, but it has a few issues, the most important of which is the long-windedness. While the sentences are grammatically correct, they are not working as effective sentences because they are trying to do too much. A sentence should really only focus on one or two specific points. This sample is trying to cover 4 points, which means no one point is being emphasized. The lack of emphasis makes it hard for the audience to understand the sentences. It can also result in important information being overlooked. A less obvious but important point is the last clause. We are positive this solution will work. This sounds like the memo is trying to convince the reader that it will work this time, that other solutions have failed. Memos need to be honest and accurate, but they also need to be even-toned. Making declarations like, "this will work," or "this time will work better," sets expectations that may not be met. Here is the revision. This modification may affect price, production time, and the materials used. The revision is more focused. The main focus is that the modification will cause changes to many aspects of the project. The aspects are mentioned, but they are presented as being subordinate, or less important, to the main point that the modification is not trivial. Here again, the revision directs the audience to additional material if the audience wants or needs to review the specific numbers. The declaration is cut because there's no need to assure the audience the modification will work. Proposing the modification inherently assumes that it'll work. This revision has more going on than those from Part 1. So let's take a closer look at how we went from the sample to the revision. The first portion of the sample is, this change will increase cost and production time and may require a re-evaluation of the materials. This sentence is splitting its focus between 3 specific points, cost, production time, and re-evaluation of materials, but not indicating which is the most important. Cost and production time are closely linked, but the re-evaluation of materials is not clearly connected. The revision focuses on the connection. This modification may affect price, production time, and the materials used. Now all 3 points are being talked about in the same way, and they focus more clearly on the possible changes to the project. The second portion of the sample contains the prediction. Because the failures have been analyzed, however, we are positive this solution will work. This portion was completely removed from the revision for 2 reasons. It isn't saying anything, and it sounds like an excuse. Few audiences will need you to tell them that you did your job and analyzed what failed, and fewer still will need you to tell them that the solution will work. It can be safely assumed that if you're proposing a solution, you think it will work. However, discuss whether or not a solution will work if there are multiple solutions. In that event, a case should be made for which solution to select. Also, if the proposed solution will only address part of the failure, then the audience needs to know what will be addressed and what needs more work. The only time you will need to reassure the audience about the solution is when it won't fix everything or there are multiple possibilities. If you have any further questions, please contact your TA. This has been a presentation of Memo Writing for ME 263 Part 2, a vidcast brought to you by Zachary Koppelman in cooperation with the Purdue Online Writing Lab and prepared for the Mechanical Engineering Writing Enhancement Program.